The Nintendo Switch Pro controller is one of my favorite controllers out there. And when playing in docked mode, a traditional controller is what I and many others prefer to play with. But let's be real for a second. As nice as that controller is, it isn't exactly cheap. So what's a guy or gal to do if you want a more traditional controller to play with, but don't want to shell out the $70 freaking for a Pro controller? There's a lot of affordable options out there, but generally it means you have to sacrifice a certain feature like rumble or wireless connectivity or motion controls. Well, fortunately, for less than $25, you can get this controller right here from Amazon that has all of the features that I mentioned. But is it any good? And how does it stack up to the Pro controller? Well, let's find out.
Okay.
So I'm going to be honest with you. I don't really know what to call this controller. It doesn't seem to have an official brand name, and the folks at TechKen were the ones kind enough to send me this controller for review, but I'm pretty sure it's one of those generic, rebranded Chinese controllers that you often see on Amazon. Regardless, the folks at TechKen were the ones to send me this controller, so I'll leave their link to their Amazon page in the description below. So, starting with the unboxing, you get the controller itself. A USB-C charging cable with no power brick, and instructions on how to pair this with your Switch. Pairing it is pretty straightforward. If you're pairing the controller for the first time, you need to go to the Change Grip page on your Switch. Hold the home button for about 5 seconds and the lights will blink fast, and then connect. After that first initial pairing, all you'll have to do to pair it to your Switch in the future is just hit the home button and it should do it automatically. My immediate impressions were pretty good with this controller. The face buttons are large enough for my liking and feel responsive. The shoulder buttons are reminiscent of that DualShock 4's, with the digital triggers also having a similar shape, yet pressed more like a Pro controller with little to no travel distance. The D-pad is a good size, albeit a bit on the mushy side. The home, capture, plus, minus, and turbo button all have the same harsh click and can be quite loud. The controller feels good in the hand overall. It's really no bigger than my Xbox One or my Switch Pro controller. And given the price, it definitely feels a lot more solid than I expected. My only initial complaint with this controller is the thumbsticks are kind of on the slippery side. They almost kind of feel like a used 360 controller. It totally works and is totally playable, but yeah, a little bit slippery for my preference. My first big session, I played with this controller for about 5 hours before it needed a charge, so its advertised 6 hours of battery life, I would say, is pretty accurate. I wasn't keeping super close tabs, so I say I trust the marketing material on this one. I couldn't personally notice much of a difference when comparing it to my Pro controller, and I loaded up Punch-Out to test the D-pad inputs and really had no problems whatsoever with my reaction timing. To test both the thumbsticks and the motion controls, I loaded up Warface, a free FPS for the Nintendo Switch. I chose Warface because you can use both the thumbsticks or gyro for aiming, and playing with this controller worked well. Well, I mean, as well as a controller can work on an FPS anyway. Nothing will beat a mouse, I'm sorry. Oh yeah, and yeah, this controller does have basic rumble. Although it can be a little bit loud and doesn't seem to have a speed setting between completely off or jet engine. Honestly, I think this nameless, I'm assuming Chinese controller is quite the hidden gem, especially for its price. It's a great affordable option for those who want a more traditional controller for couch play, and can even make a great Player 2 controller that doesn't totally suck for your friends to use. Given my experience with this thing, it definitely earns my recommendation. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that about does it for this video. Thank you so much for checking out the video and the channel. I'd also like to give a big thank you to the folks at TechKen for providing this controller for review. For transparency's sake, they provided this controller for a review. All of the thoughts and opinions are my own, and they won't see this video until it actually uploads. With that being said, if you did like this video, please do consider giving it a thumbs up, as it is the best way to help out a small channel like us to get this video seen and pushed through the YouTube algorithm. If you like this kind of content and you want to see more, do consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell icon in the corner. We do videos every Monday and Friday and live stream on Wednesday nights, usually around 9 PM Central Time. Feel free to follow us on all the social media stuff like Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And lastly, I do want to just give a big shout out to all of you who have supported us so far. We recently hit our big milestone of 200 subscribers, and we are very appreciative of that. The channel's been really gaining attention and growing really quickly, and we are thankful for all of the support and love that we've been given so far. So again, thank you so much. But that's seriously enough rambling out of me. Thanks again so much for watching. My name is Blake, and for all things tech, games, movies, and other nerdy things in between, be sure to subscribe to Digital Cynics. Have a good one, everyone.